I want to introduce Paul Kuchnikov now, who is coming to the studio. Paul is with AEP Baltic Link Recruitment. Afternoon to you again.
Hello.
You help people, well, predominantly people from kind of areas of Eastern Europe, find work in Britain, in Northamptonshire.
Yes.
This would normally be considered the more kind of unskilled work?
Yeah, factory work.
What kind of areas? Packing and...
Packing, loading, unloading, this sort of things, factory type of job.
Okay, so that would be considered the more menial work. And yep. Traditionally, before the horrendous economic conditions, we were hearing that British people weren't really willing to do that type of work.
Yep.
And you were finding people from Eastern Europe that were willing to come here and do that work and filling that job market. What's it like at the moment? Because the pound's not particularly strong at the moment, and it's not making good sense for people to come and work here.
What can I say? Oh, dear. Yeah. That's what's happening. You know, there are massive redundancies happening right now. Yeah, I had... redundancies up to 50% of the workforce. You know, I cannot really see how well down it can go or get worse. Yeah, but every day after watching TV news, you know, I'm getting frightened. What's going to happen next?
So let's just talk about your business and what you're doing. Do you have jobs that are on your books, but you haven't got the personnel to fill those jobs?
Not anymore. I'll give you a very interesting example. Before, I was struggling to find people to work in a foam factory, what is a very warm place here in England. And now I've got a waiting list to work in a fish factory up to in Fort William. You know, so it does make a difference. You know, I get so many phone calls from people who just lost the work, you know, and apparently I'm not only getting phone calls from Eastern Europeans.
So British-born people are trying to get work through you as well?
Yeah, I'm just meeting my friends on the street, you know, and they say, oh, by the way, do you have any jobs available? And I say, unfortunately not.
So it's a very quiet on the jobs front. Fewer people coming from Eastern Europe than are people going home to their native countries because there isn't the work here?
I think those people who... didn't try to settle in here, like was trying to find a better place, and they like stuck in the middle. You know, they want to go home, but there is no job. It's even worse in there, you know. And the government, even before, the government was encouraging to people to come back, but now the government directly saying, go back, go work in there. But the thing is, there is no job.
Sure. So from your experience, because I have been arguing that, is there a suggestion that some people that may have had a pretty relatively well-paid job who have been made redundant, are they unwilling to downsize and do the more menial stuff, the more unskilled jobs? Are you saying that, well, there isn't an awful lot of that work around even if you wanted to do it?
Exactly, yeah.
And it's not there.
But if, to be honest with you, some people are still not really willing to do the menial job. They'd rather sit at home.
Really?
You know, and wait.
And so if there is somebody listening now, like some of the callers that we've had, that are desperately looking for work and are willing to do anything, even though they may be really well qualified, but they are willing to do anything, would you be able to find that person work?
Unfortunately, it's very difficult right now.
The jobs aren't there.
Every week I get redundancies. So every week I need to tell people, I'm sorry, but your job is gone. Mm-hmm. You know, and if somebody calls me, I just ask them, please leave information about you and I'll try to get back in touch with you. But it's like one of those standard replies.
And do you see an end in sight? I mean, this would be difficult just for you personally, if you haven't got the business.
Yeah, well, I went to study to uni right now, you know, trying to get another kind of qualification, which I hope will bring me some advantage in the future.
Sure, but at the moment, it's not looking too rosy.
I hope it will get better, but as everybody says, it's going to be a little bit tough before it's getting better.
Sure. Paul, good to see you again. Good
Thank
luck with it.
Indeed.
Thank you for coming in again.
Thank you.
Thank you. Paul Kuchnikov there. He was from AEP Baltic Link Recruitment. So there, the word from the ground is that even if you wanted to do something that would be considered an unskilled or manual labour, Paul's saying it's very quiet on the ground. The jobs are not there.